If you were to name the Old Testament prophet who is most associated with our season of Advent, whom would you name? Hello, this is Father James Kubicki of the Apostleship of Prayer. Do you think of the prophet Isaiah? Readings from the book of the prophet Isaiah appear throughout Advent, including today. The first reading at Mass today is from chapter 40, which is part of one of the most consoling sections of the Bible. When these words were first written, they were intended for the Jewish people who had been taken into exile in Babylon. The prophet writes to them words of hope that they would soon be able to return to their native land. In today's reading, Isaiah invites us to look up at the sky with all its stars and to recognize that God is the one who created the entire universe with all its stars and planets, and God also created human life. Albert Einstein once wrote that the possibility of life originating by accident is comparable to the unabridged dictionary resulting from an explosion at a print shop. In other words, any honest person has to say that the world and life itself could not have just happened. Creation shows us a creator who has a purpose in creating. God's ultimate purpose in creating the world and the human creatures who inhabit it is love. We're created for union with God. And God doesn't want anything, even sin and death, to get in the way of that. Knowing that, we can say with Isaiah today, "They that hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar as with eagle's wings. They will run and not grow weary, walk and not grow faint."